Welcome in a universe community. My name is Sanchita Pandey and our topic for today is ways to increase your output. How many times have you wondered, you had more time with you so that you could finish all the work in hand. All you have to do is organize and manage your time. Actually, you have to manage how you go about doing your work. So the first way to increase your output is by feeling good. This comes as a surprise to you because energy is everything. First of all, you must feel like doing that work. So you must have some kind of positive energy, enthusiasm for doing that work. And if you are feeling good, you'll want to bring in more creativity. You'll want to complete the task in hand. So the first way to increase your output is to see how you're feeling all day long. Your emotions are very important because according to your emotions, that is the energy you'll feel in your body. So when the flow of energy is good, you feel enthusiastic, you want to finish your work. That is how the output will be really good. The second way to increase your output is by choosing your response throughout the day. Now, there'll be different people you'll meet. Situations will be different. Now, you have to choose. You have to keep aligned with your inner core, that is the inner spirit within you. And once you make up your mind that you'll just stay calm and aligned, no matter what happens on the outside, no matter how somebody behaves with you, then you can go about doing your work nicely. Otherwise, what happens? Somebody comes, this person is curt and unkind towards you. And now you'll start thinking about why this person said this to me. Why is everybody behaving like this? And then what happens? The concentration in your work is gone. So the output will be not as good as it would have been. So you have to remain aligned throughout the day. The third way to increase your output is by organizing everything. Keep everything at the right place so that you do not have to waste time going about finding things. Where is my pen? Where have I kept that diary? So organize. And another thing is organize in your mind. Have a short to-do list. Okay, these are the three things I must finish today. And the sequence can differ, but still you have this in mind. You have planned at least a short list. Okay, this is something I must complete today. And so you'll manage your time accordingly. Fourth way to increase your output is learn to say no to distractions. Distractions may come in the form of people, conversations, useless conversations, just discussing politics and anything. But when you know you have not completed your work and this is something in your to-do list today, then you cannot make everybody accessible all the time. If you are doing it, then somewhere you will have to sacrifice on the output in your work. Now, if you have really made up your mind to finish something, that work in hand, then you have to say no to things that are not that important. So prioritize, and then when you prioritize, you have to keep your work in mind all the time so that you don't get distracted anytime during the day. Now, it doesn't mean that there should be no leisure time. There must be leisure time, talk to people, but you must just keep this in mind. You have to finish this amount of work and it must be done. Now you know how much of leisure is important. What is the ratio between your resting time and your work time? That is only you can decide. So that is how you can increase your output. Now, work doesn't mean that you do not take care of your physical and mental health. Have food at the right time. Have your lunch at the right time and then go back to working again. Then have a lot of water in between. Have a good night's sleep so that you are active throughout the day. The next day you must be active. But if you have not slept properly, You will feel lethargic somewhere, you will feel sleepy, again the output won't be there. So for good output in your work, you have to take care of your mental and physical health. Sleep properly, eat properly. It is like if you are not eating properly, good nutritious food, then it is like I want to roam around in my car but I don't have the time to fill in petrol. So that is not possible. So you have to take out time to take care of yourself physically and mentally. You may experience negative reactions from people throughout the day. So don't give rent-free space in your mind. Somebody misbehaves, but then this person enjoys so much of importance and rent-free space in your mind. You keep thinking about this person throughout the day. You speak about this person with your friends, your relatives, your family members. Why? So just ignore, let it go and concentrate in your core job, your core work that you have decided to finish today. Because whatever somebody is saying to you, or you don't have to believe everything everybody says. And if they are curt, it shows how they are feeling. It is about them. It is not about you at all, because they are not feeling good. So they come and open up, you know, throw up all the garbage upon you. Now it is up to you to receive that garbage or not. You say no to the garbage and then you are free. You are free to go about doing your work again and the output will be really good. Another way to increase your output is by prioritizing your work. You should know what is the priority, the first priority, the first task that you must complete today. And it must be done. No procrastination, no excuses. Stop giving excuses for not doing something well. So once you have decided in your mind, I must finish this work, it must be done. So prioritize. Follow that to-do list sincerely. Now it is between you and what you have prepared for yourself. And it will give a lot of sense of achievement to you once it is done. If you know that another person knows how to do this job really well, then it is a good idea to delegate. It is a good idea to outsource that work so that you can find time to concentrate on other work in your list. That is how you can increase your output. It is a good idea to outsource your work to somebody who can possibly do it in a better way, who is more skilled in that particular field, and gradually you can also learn how to do it well. We take care of our material things. Time is also a currency, and once it passes by, it doesn't come back again to you. So all you have with you is this moment. This moment is all you have. That is why it is known as the gift, the present. Take care of the time you have in your hands. Utilize it in the best possible way and use your time wisely. Do not waste and squander your time in doing jobs which are not required to do at all. So that is why you should organize, you should prioritize, you should know what is your goal for today. When you take care of the seconds, the hours will take care of themselves. How about multitasking? Multitasking is a farce. Take up one job, do it well, then go to another, and then otherwise lot of confusion will take place. Sometimes for little jobs it is okay, one big job and two small jobs you are completing side by side, that is fine. But watching TV and doing your work, listening to songs and doing your work, that sort of multitasking will only be a hindrance to absolute concentration in your work. So there is a time to work, there is a time to play. When you work, just work. Concentrate on your work, give your best and do your work in the best possible manner. That is how you'll get the best output for the day. And then there is a time to play, so you can just relax, do whatever you love to do. That is how you can increase your output for today. So for tomorrow, start early in the morning, get up early, plan a short to-do list and see that you adhere to that list, you are able to complete that list, and all the distractions that come midway, you have to say no to those distractions. So it all depends on you. Like I say, everything depends on you. Everything begins with you, your belief. If you believe whatever you have learned here, you'll be able to implement tomorrow, then yes, it will be done. And let your output be really good tomorrow. Complete more work so that you feel better. You get a sense of achievement after finishing your work. And then there is no procrastination. Organize your life. Organize your thoughts in your mind. That is how you will see better organization skills. As far as your job is concerned, as far as how you go about doing your work is concerned, in everything, that sort of attitude will be seen. So best of luck. Thank you so much, Inner Universe community. It is always nice to connect with you. I love you, and I wish lot of abundance, peace, love and happiness in your life. Thank you for joining me here. Namaste.